Welcome to First Colleen. We're so glad to see you here. Find someone you haven't met this morning. Say hello. Continue our worship through greeting your neighbor.
Sir.
All right, as you find your way back to your pew, back to your seat, you may have a seat. Have a seat. If you'll do me a favor, look down at the end of your pew, you see a white folder. If you wouldn't mind helping us by filling that out, let us know that you're here. If you're here for the very first time, thank you so much for being here, and it's great to have you. We have a couple of big things going on this week. This next week will be Shindigada. Shindigada is a strange name for a youth week. And so the youth will be up here from Tuesday to Friday in the evenings. They've invited three other churches to come and join us. So we've got over 100 people are going to be in and around the building doing worship and games and meals, and then ending the week at the Lions Club pool. Registration for that is still open on the website if you want to jump in. If your youth would like to join us, we'd love to have them here with us. So that's Shindigada. And then this last week, we also had Vacation Bible School. We're going to show you a video on that in just a moment. I want to give you a heads up on August 26th. That's a few weeks away. On August 26th, we'll have one service. Everybody say one service. Everybody say not at 9:30. Okay, so you know, you've been told. It'll be at 10 o'clock. So you're welcome to come half an hour early to church that day if you'd like, but we'll have one service in here at 10 o'clock. We're going to celebrate where the church has been, and we're going to celebrate where the church is going, and then we're going to follow it with a very Methodist thing, a potluck. And so we'll have a potluck on August 26th, so get your casserole dishes ready, and we'll be excited about that. I want to tell this service one extra note for today, and that is that we are scheduling a Financial Peace University class to begin September 5th. If you've never taken Financial Peace University, I can't tell you how beneficial that's been to my family. And so we will lead that on Wednesday nights, starting the Wednesday after Labor Day. We'll tell you more about registration and all of that later. But if you're a family, you've never taken Financial Peace, you need to get that one under your belt. It's pretty amazing. All right, well, we want to begin to celebrate what happened this last week with Vacation Bible School. So we've got a video that's going to kick off our kids' time, and then we're going to invite the kids to come down and sing for us.
And the waves are crashing all around.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I am looking for our VBS leaders that are going to come down and share a little bit more about the week. And going once. All right, well, I'll tell you what. Let's invite all the kids to come down for a kids' message. We're going to sing one of our VBS songs called My Lighthouse. So, children, come on down. Here we go. Come on down. Come on down. Good morning, everybody. Howdy, howdy, howdy. Lily. Okay, who's leading this? Here we go. All right. You got red? Red?
All right. We from VBS just want to say thank you, church. It was an amazing experience. We appreciate everything you guys did to help us facilitate VBS. It was wonderful. The kids learned so much. They left every night so happy, and we had some awesome volunteers that stepped up to help lead these kids and show them God's love. God's love. All right, so we can play the music.
In my wrestling, in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. My lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
Awesome, awesome. So a huge word of thanks to all the children that joined us for VBS, for all the adults. We had a group of adults that were up here for about 2 weeks straight getting things ready for VBS, setting the decorations up and getting things ready. Thank you so much for all of the amazing work. Y'all all did such a great, great job. So tell you what, let's end with a prayer, and then the kids are going to go back with the kids ministry team for their time together. All right, let's bow and pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving us. Thank you for rescuing us. Help us follow you. Help us love you. Amen. All right. Thanks, guys. Y'all head back. Good work. All right. Additional thanks to all the children that came forward that weren't at VBS that were just confused for about 3 minutes. So, our ushers are going to come forward for offering this morning. So we celebrate all of the ministries of the church. And let's pray. God, we thank you for the many celebrations of this church, for the children, for the youth that will be here this next week. We pray, God, for the mission trip as they head to Louisiana early this morning. And we ask that all of this is part of building up your kingdom here in Killeen, in this community, and around the world. We ask as we give back to you now just a portion of what you've placed in our hands, that we do so with an offering heart that wants to connect more with the things that you're doing. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Our God. You reign forever, our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. You will not fade, you won't grow weary. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
Stand and sing with us.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not think you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God, you do not think you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
When you move, I'll move. I will follow.
are good, all your ways are sure. I will trust in you alone, higher than my sight, higher than my life. I will trust in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. Where you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Where you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah. In you there's life everlasting. In you there's freedom for my soul. In you there's joy. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Who you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. In this life I lose, I will follow you. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. You love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow you.
Team. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Excellent, excellent. Good morning. Good morning. We're going to continue our message series on Moses today, and we're looking at the burning bush. And there are 87 different ways to preach on the burning bush. You can talk about calling, you can talk about all kinds of different things, but today I want to focus on one thing. I want to go ahead and share the question with you now so that we can take that question with us through the message today. And the question is this: where do you find the holy? Where do you find the holy? Let's think about that as we get into our message today. Let's pray. God, we thank you for this morning, for this congregation, and the work that you've placed in our hands. We ask now as we turn to your word that you would speak to us, to our hearts and unto our minds, to mold us and guide us and continue to create in us the disciple you've created us in joy to be. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. First, a reading from Psalm 139. Where could I go to get away from your spirit? Where could I go to escape your presence? If I went up to heaven, you would be there. If I went down to the grave, you would be there too. If I could fly on the wings of dawn, stopping to rest only on the far side of the ocean, even there, your hand would guide me. Even there, your strong hand would hold me tight. If I said the darkness will definitely hide me, the light will become night around me. Even then, the darkness isn't too dark for you. Nighttime would shine bright as day, because darkness is the same as light to you. Where do you find the holy? Since last Sunday, it's been 80 years for Moses. Last week we talked about Moses and his birth and the Nile and courageous women that continued God's story even through the genocide of the young Israel boys. 40 years went by as Moses was a prince, was raised as a prince, as a royal in Egypt. Around his 40th birthday, he has an identity crisis as he sees one of his own, a Hebrew, being abused. And he takes the life of one of the guards, and he hides the guard in the sand. Pharaoh finds out, and Pharaoh begins to go after Moses, so Moses runs. And Moses ran as far away as he thought he could run from all of that. He ends up off with a family, a Midianite family, out in the middle of the desert. Not even in the desert, but the Bible even says in the far end of the desert, about as far away as you could get. And he spends 40 years there being an ordinary shepherd, a shepherd in hiding, doing a common job, kind of low on the totem pole of jobs, being a shepherd. He's out there in a place called Horeb, and Horeb means wasteland and dried up ground. Any Texans know about dried up ground right now? When you go in the backyard and it crunches underneath your feet? I know that's us at our house right now. So out there, far from everything else, in the middle of his regular job, they don't tell us when, I just kind of guess it's like Wednesday at 2 o'clock. Out there doing a common thing is when Moses meets God. And Moses has this conversation with God. Let's read that from Exodus 3, the first 6 verses. Moses was taking care of the flock for his father-in-law Jethro, Midian's priest. He led his flock out to the edge of the desert, and he came to God. The Lord's messenger appeared to him in a flame of fire in the middle of a bush. Moses saw that the bush was in flames, but he didn't burn up. Then Moses said to himself, "Let me check out this amazing sight and find out why the bush isn't burning up." When the Lord saw that he was coming to look, God called to him out of the bush, "Moses, Moses." Moses said, "I'm here." Then the Lord said, "Don't come any closer. Take off your sandals, because you're on holy ground." He continued, "I am the God of your father, Abraham's God, Isaac's God, and Jacob's God." And Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at God. So Moses sees this bush, he sees that it's on fire, but it's not burning up anything, and he takes the initiative to go and to check out what it is that's going on. God says, "Don't come any closer. Take off your sandals." That's not a common practice for us that much anymore. But as I look around the room, I want to make really sure. Well, okay. Okay, so sometimes in holy places, we take our hat off, right? Or we pray, and everyone says, "Everyone remove your hat. We're about to pray." Well, that's similar to take your sandals off. We're going to take our sandals off because it's a holy place and a holy moment. Think about for a second when you take your shoes off and when you take your shoes off. When you go to the beach, you take your shoes off. Why? Because you want to feel the sand in between your toes. And when you feel the sand in between your toes on the beach, you become a little more aware of what's going on at the beach. When I'm in my backyard right now, I don't want to walk out barefooted because it's crunchy and it hurts to be in my backyard right now. When it's dark at night, and you're in your bedroom, and for some reason you need to get up and walk around your bedroom. You can't see, and you can't really use your hands because there's nothing in front of you, but your feet suddenly begin to see for you. Your feet become very valuable, and you're very careful not to kick the corner of the bed, and in our house, not to step on the dog that might be sleeping at your feet. In our house, you have to be sure not to step on a Lego, or you'll wake the whole house up. When Moses sees the holy, he takes his shoes off. And out there in the middle of the desert, in the far end of the desert, doing his everyday job that he had been doing for 40 years, that was the place that became holy, and that was the place that God met with Moses. Where do you find the holy? Now, we create space for worship. We've created this sanctuary for worship. Youth will be in here tonight working to make this an even more of a worshipful space for Shindigata and for the youth. We have conferences that we go to, and we bring in national speakers to come to these places to speak to us so that we can create a holy place and a holy space. We go to camp. We go on mission trips. Here in Exodus, it's just a regular bush, like all the other bushes out in the desert. That was the place that became holy. Now, we can get caught thinking that holy is a sometimes thing. We can get caught separating, well, these times are holy. Sunday morning at 9:30 is holy. But other times are not holy. Other times we can just be in here and do Guns N' Roses and have a blast, right? Okay. Or somewhere else or some other place. Sometimes we can get caught thinking holy is a someplace thing, that this certain place is a holy place, but others are not. With all the other times and other places just being ordinary and being common, that we separate the spiritual and the earthly. But here's a story where Moses found the spiritual amongst the most common, amongst the most earthly that there was, on a Wednesday at 2:00. Rob Bell is a writer, and he speaks a little bit to this idea of where he finds holy. He says, your life matters. How you prepare your food, how you deal with your neighbor, how you handle conflict. You are on holy ground. This is not a random, accidental phenomenon we know to be you, but your entire life takes place under a wide horizon of holiness and sanctity. Respect the mundane and the everyday, because it's there that the divine is found. But we miss that, don't we? We miss the ordinary. We miss the mundane because we're distracted. Right, youth? We're distracted? Yes. Yeah. Yeah. They were distracted. We miss the ordinary. We miss the mundane because we're too busy. And because we think the only time we're supposed to connect our heads with God is during this hour. And then we just get so busy we can't even figure out where we are, up or down, left or right, the rest of the week. And so we limit God and we say, God, we are ready for the holy during these moments. God, we're ready for the holy in the morning when I read my devotional book, and then I'm off to the races, and good luck trying to keep up with me, right? We make these separations, and we miss the significant amount of time that God wants to connect with us, and God wants to speak with us, and God wants to touch us in the middle of our daily lives. Thankfully, Moses was not distracted. Moses wasn't too busy. Moses was able to say, I need to go look and see what that is. I want to see what God might be saying to me now. We overlook the ordinary. We overlook the common. That conversation you had at the grocery store, that's very common. That text message you sent someone this week just to say, hey, how you doing? That's very common. But that's holy. And those are the holy times in the middle of our ordinary, common lives when God speaks to us and we can speak to God. Where do you find the holy. There's a quote that my beautiful wife shared with me this week. She'll do that from time to time. She'll know what I'm preaching on, and she's like, you really need to look at this one. And so she shared this one with me. It's from a while back, someone named Elizabeth Barrett Browning. Earth is crammed with heaven. I like that. Earth is crammed with heaven, and every common bush afire with God. But only he who sees takes off his shoes. There is the holy all around us. There is the holy everywhere we look. There is the holy at the YMCA. There is the holy at Meet the Teacher Night. There is a holy at the teacher conference after school. I mean, all that, right? Okay? But only he who sees takes off his shoes. Where do you find the holy? This last week, we've seen the holy here. We've had vacation Bible school. We had children running up and down the halls asking amazing, beautiful, innocent questions about God and who God is. This next week will be holy, and youth will be here. And they'll be on their knees in prayer asking about God and being distracted and how we can focus our life. These are holy places. These are holy times, and let's seek those. The one that's been on my mind this last week are teacher-parent meetings, because I know they're coming up. I think some of y'all might start school on Thursday, and I apologize as your pastor to bring this up 4 days before you're supposed to get back to work. You've already been in your rooms, I know. But think about it. It's not just a mundane, ordinary task. You've got parents coming into you that are unsure about what they're doing for their kids, and they're unsure about what they're doing, and they need guidance, and they need hope, and they need a word from you that they're doing the right thing for their kids. And so suddenly, that becomes a holy moment. It becomes a holy moment when you as a teacher can share that hope with a parent that's a little lost and needs some guidance and needs some help. It's a holy moment when you get to share that with a child, when you're not sure exactly what that child's life looks like when they get on the bus and they go home every night. It's a holy moment, and they're all around us. Every bush is afire with God, but it takes us to be able to see it and to be able to connect to it. Where do you see the holy? Where will you see the holy this week? Where will you see the holy once you've gone out these doors and you get in your car and you drive home? I want to do something with us as we close our message today. I want to sing a song with you. It's a song that I learned at camp years ago, and I think it's been out there long enough that some of us are going to know this. If you don't, that's perfectly acceptable. But I want us to sing it, and I want to ask you a question. We're gonna sing it again, okay? If you know the song, sing with me. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power and his grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Now, typically, if you know that song, typically when we sing that song, we're in worship. Typically when we sing this song, we're at the end of a week of camp, and we have youth that their minds have just been on fire for God, and we sing this at the end of an Emmaus event when everybody's in that holy moment. And so when we sing this song, we're thinking about church, and we're thinking about us, and we're thinking about the sanctuary, and we're saying, yes, in this place, God is present, and amen to that. Here's what I want you to think about. What is the most ordinary place that you will be this week? Where, what is the most common thing that you're going to do this next week? For some of you, it's the cubicle that you'll go back to on Monday. For some of you, it's a certain aisle on HEB, right? What is the most common place, common thing that you'll be at this week? It's not Shindigata youth, it's something else. What's the most common, ordinary thing? Some of us have doctor's appointments this week. That's exciting, isn't it? All right. Some of us have to go get our oil changed, and we're going to sit there for 10 minutes in the waiting room, listening to the news blare loudly and looking around at the old newspapers. What's the most common, ordinary thing that you're going to do? Now, I want you to put yourself in that place. I want you to look around and see some of the faces that you're going to see in that common, ordinary place. And I want to ask you, can that be a holy moment? Can that be a time where the bush is a fire for God? I want to suggest it is. So put yourself in that place. We're going to sing this one more time as if that is the place where this song is most appropriate. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. I can feel His mighty power and His grace. I can hear the brush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Good job, choir. Thank you. Let's pray. God, we thank You for Your presence. And God, we claim that we too often limit that. We think of Your presence in certain people. Typically, those people look like us and they think like us. They live in the same places that we live. And we limit You because we only think we're going to see You at certain times when we do the work and we open up our eyes. And God, we have a story this morning of Your presence and Your power and Your awe meeting Moses on Wednesday at 2 o'clock out in the field. God, may we have eyes that see the holy around us. The holy in all the places that we go this next week. Maybe you'd be aware. May we capture those moments in our heart and be more aware of You and Your work in this world this next week. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. This morning I'd like to read the traditional liturgy for communion called the Great Thanksgiving. If you're familiar with this and able to follow along, we'd invite you to do so. If you're not familiar with it and you just want to sit back and listen, that's also fine. Friends, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and a joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to You. Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, You formed us in Your image. You breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, Your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through the prophets. And so with Your people on earth, and all the company of heaven, we praise Your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of Your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are You, and blessed is Your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed Him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick. He fed the hungry. He ate with sinners. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church. You delivered us from slavery to sin and death and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always. In the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, he gave thanks to you, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice. In union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith, Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world and for this community the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. I want to invite the youth and those who are to help with communion to come forward. Our youth are going to serve us today, which is appropriate. Sure, thank you. I'm sorry. I have a special altar rail offering today. Just down the hill is the MCH, Methodist Children's Home Outreach Center, and that is connected to the Methodist Church through the work in Waco. And so our communion rail offering is going to support the families that they support this morning. And so the way that works, if you'd like to leave a donation at the altar rail, that will all be sent to that area. All right. Friends, the body of Christ broken for you and broken for the world, and the blood of Christ shed for you, for your healing, for your wholeness, so that the weights might fall and we might live in freedom. Amen. You'll come serve with me. Body of Christ broken for you. Body of Christ. Body of Christ broken for you. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Okay. Hey guys, body of Christ.
at a loss for words.
In the United Methodist Church, this table is open to anyone and everyone. So you don't have to be a member here. You don't have to be Methodist to come forward and take communion. If it's your preference to not take communion, we want to honor that as well. If you want to remain seated in your pew, you can do that. We do have a gluten-free option up here at the front if you would like to come and receive from there. But as you're ready, you may come forward.
Father, thanks for all your blessings of this past week, both seen and unseen. Thanks for forgiving our sins that we commit by omission and commission. Please watch over all of our sick members and their families, wherever they may be. Watch over our military members who are deployed and their families as well. Please watch over your church universal, and especially First United Methodist Church. And thank you for a great VBS. And bring your blessings upon Shindigata this next week. Give safe traveling mercies to our mission team who are even now on the road down to Baldwin, Mississippi, or Baldwin, Louisiana, at UMCOR, and all that they will do. May they have a great ministry at UMCOR this week and bring them safely back to us next, or this coming Friday. Let us join together in the prayer that you taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever.
Amen. Thank you, Dean. Church, it's been great to be with you this morning. We've had an exciting week. We've got another exciting week ahead of us. For those of you that are helping out and volunteering and helping, thank you again so much for helping to make this work continue here at First Clean. If you're interested in knowing more about the church, we would love a chance to sit and talk to you. We have a monthly welcome meal where you can come and hear more about the church and what's going on. We would love to talk to you about joining the church. We would love to receive you. Make this the place where you continue your journey of faith with us. We want to find a place for you to worship and to be known, and we want to find a place for you to serve, and so we can serve you as well. There's information in your pew, a little bit more about that if you're interested, or just let us know. You could put something in your white folder as well. But let's stand and let's sing as we begin to get ready to head out into the world.
Before the world was made, before you spoke it to be, you were the King of Kings. Yeah, you were. And now you're reigning still, enthroned above all things. Angels and saints cry out, we join them as we sing. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God forever. Glory to God, glory to God forever. Creator God, you gave me breath so I could praise your great and matchless name all my days. So let my whole life be a blazing offering, a life that shouts and sings the greatness of our King. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God forever. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God forever. Glory to God, glory to God forever. Glory to God, glory to God.